Hello everyone, I'm going to make a resin geode cake stand again, but this time in a nice green, light blue color. And I'm also going to reuse my silicon barriers again, and so far I'm very happy with these silicon barriers. So for the new people to my channel that like resin tutorials like this one, or tutorials of acrylics, alcohol ink, also geodes on MDF or freeform, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all. That's very important because then you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So, I'm going to make a cake stand again, and in a cream light blue color. And the first color is a mixture of two pigments of my own. I mix the white lily together with a little bit of golden beach so that it gets more creamy. So on the outside a nice cream color. Yeah, and I'm very happy with these silicone barriers because the leakage I had with my two other cake stands was minimal and also very thin, so I could take it off very easy. And this is these silicone barriers work not that messy as 100% tube silicone, and it also doesn't have a smell. So far I'm very pleased with these silicone barriers. So in the middle, an alcohol ink again, and this is the Pinata Baia Blue, and I also mixed in some Sparkle White, one of my own natural mica pigments. It's very nice, it looks like glitter, but it's not. And also this will not sink to the bottom, and that's why I like this pigment very much. So the heat gun for the air bubbles, and I'm going to fill this whole layer with the Baia Blue with the Sparkle White mixed in it. If you are interested in my own natural mica pigments, the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box. They are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. Also her link to her Etsy shop is in the description box, and we have some nice discounts. And for the people in USA, if you order above $30, then you get free shipping, so that's great. So if you're curious, please check out the description box. So I'm going to let these colors bleed into each other, the nice creamy color, the white lily together with the golden beach, and the alcohol ink. And also for the people that have questions about my base, I'm using an acetate sheet, and it's very shiny, so that's why the back is also shiny, and it's more heat resistant than normal plastic. So now I'm starting with a puddle technique, and in the middle I'm using the Color Obsession Bonera Blue, very opaque light blue color. So on top of the alcohol ink, I'm pouring this puddle of Bonera Blue. And on top of the Bonera Blue, I'm using the Resin Pro White Paste again. So also in the middle, on top of the Bonera Blue. And on top of the white, again, the alcohol ink, the Baia Blue. And if you want to know how I make the barriers, I will put the link in the right corner of the video. Then you can see how I make these silicon barriers. And again the Bonaire blue in the middle, a small puddle. And you can already see that the cream color on the outside is bleeding into the Baia blue, very nice. And the white paste of Resin Pro. Also all the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box, as I always do with the links to the websites. And on top of the white, I'm using clear resin and I mix some sparkle white in it. And I'm pouring it from up high, so the stream gets thinner. And then it goes all the way through the colors to the bottom. There you can see it, so that the center will be more transparent. And I want this cake stand to be very sparkly, that's why I mixed the sparkle white in both the clear but also in the alcohol ink. And this way I'm building up the puddle. And for the resin I'm using the Resin Pro Art Pro resin again. And yeah, I think it's an amazing resin. For me, it's the right thickness and it has an amazing finish, so I'm very pleased with this resin. And for the people that are wondering, because I also get questions, is it food safe? No, this resin isn't food safe. You can use food safe resin, because also Resin Pro has a food safe resin. But when I use a cake stand, I always... our cupcakes come in a nice wrapped paper, so there is no direct contact with the resin, and also our chocolates are wrapped in a nice paper. But yeah, there was also someone that suggested why not pour a clear layer of a food safe resin first. So that I think that was a great idea, so that's what I'm going to do in upcoming videos, that I will be pouring first a layer of clear food safe resin and then start with this what you now see me do, and then after this is done again a thin layer of the food safe resin, so then it's totally food safe. So that's what I'm going to do in upcoming videos. And also I got some questions about bending. The larger shape is about 25 centimeters, so that will be directly on your table, so no risk for bending. The middle one is about 18 centimeters and the smaller one is 15 centimeters, so, and they are thick enough, so if you don't put anything heavy on it, then they will not, then the risk is very low that they will bend. And first of all, you need to let this dry, cure for about 1 month before you can use it. And also don't place it in the sun for too long, because every resin will get soft if you place it for hours in the sun, and also it will yellow then much faster. And that's with all resins, so not only this resin, also the other brands of resin. So again, I'm using some clear with some sparkle white in it. In the middle. And also for the people that want to know how I drill the holes in the middle, or how I put the cake stand together, I also made a video about that. I will also put a link in the right corner so that you can see how that is done. And I also want to mention I have 4 promo codes now. I have a promo code of Resin Pro Company, and if you order on the UK side or the German side, then you get 10% discount if you use my code Petra. I have a promo code of Arteza Art Supplies. If you use my code Petra Youngblood, then you get 10% discount. I'm also an affiliate of Jackson's Art Supply. If you are a new customer there and you place your first order, then you get 10% discount if you do that through my links. And I also have a promo code of Eli Gem Resin Supplies, the German website. If you use my code Petra10, then you get 10% discount on your order. So, all great discounts. Everything is in the description box. So, if you're curious, please check it out. And the colors are bleeding nicely together. Hopefully I have a nice backside so that this cake stand can be used on both sides. So I'm almost done with filling in the shapes, the molds. And then I need to let this dry. And after an hour I will show you a close-up so that you can see how much it has changed. So it's 1 hour later and it changed a lot. I think it looks great. I like these colors together. It's very subtle and very light. I also like that. And the creamy color has some nice effects. Yeah, I'm very pleased. Also the sparkle white. You can see it sparkle in the middle, in the center. Very nice. And so far, no leakage, so that's good. And also for the people that question, I only cleaned my acetate sheet and also the bottom of the silicon barriers with a little bit of alcohol. And then I just laid them down on the acetate sheet. I pressed a little bit on top of the silicon barriers. And that's that is all that I've done. So no hot glue gun or whatever to seal it, no. So this is working so far, this is working very good. At the end of this video I will show you a close-up, then you can see the effects much better. But so far I'm liking this side very much. Yeah, hopefully what I already mentioned, I hope I have a nice backside. But yeah, I need to let this dry first for 24 hours before I can take it out of the mold. So we are 24 hours later, now I can start to take the shapes out of the mold. So I press the silicon barriers to the outside and it goes very easy, almost no pressure, and then I take it away. There you can see it. And it dried very well. The last one. And so far it looks that I can use these silicon barriers over and over again, so that's good. Now I press my acetate sheet to the bottom, and then I can lift them, and then it's loose. I always do this very carefully because they are still a little bit bendy, so I need to watch out. And again, almost no leakage, only a few parts with very thin leakage, but I can take them off very easy, so no problem there. So they are loose from my acetate sheet. Now we can take a closer look. Very curious how the backside looks. The smaller one is okay, no leakage. And this is the backside, very nice. Very subtle effects, so I like that also. Now the middle one. A little bit of leakage there. And that is the backside. It sparkles a lot. At the end of the video you can see it much better, the sparkle. There I'm showing you the very thin leakage I have. With a very sharp knife you can take it off. It looks very beautiful. This is a close-up from the front side. There you can see the nice light blue color with the cream, with the really nice effects. And the sparkle of the sparkle white in the middle. The transparent center. It sparkles a lot, and that's because of the sparkle white, what I mentioned, but also the cream color, the white lily together with the golden beach. And the middle shape. Yeah, very nice. And now a close-up of the backside. This backside sparkles much more. Hope you can see it. And it has some really nice effects. Yeah, there you can see the sparkle already from the sparkle white. And a really nice ring effects. Yeah, I'm very pleased also with the backside. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take away the very thin leakage I have. And I'm also going to very lightly sand the top, so the front side, on the edge. Because I have a little bit of a raised edge there. And I'm going to use my nail file, my paper nail file for that. And then I'm also going to use the gilding paint again in the silver color on the edges. And of course I need to drill those holes in the middle and put the hardware in it. But yeah, I'm very pleased with this color and with the sparkle. You all know I love sparkle. There you can see the effects. So this is the cake stand, and this is a close-up of the front side. I have it outside in the sun, and it's such a nice color, that light blue, but also the cream. together with the cream color. And you can already see I have used the silver gilding paint. I think that looks really nice. Yeah, I'm very pleased with this cake stand. Also with the other two, but also this one is also nice. Nice effects. A little bit closer now. Very difficult to film this because of the sparkle. It almost, my camera almost can't focus because of the sparkle. And this is the close-up of the backside. I'm also liking this effect. Very nice. And it sparkles a lot. So let me know what you think of my cake stand. If you like the front or the back or both. I like both. And I like it that I can use it on both sides. All the information where I buy my materials is in the description box. Please check it out. And also the promo codes I mentioned. And my Facebook page and my Instagram is also in the description box. Also the link to my Amazon influencer store for the USA, but also for the Netherlands. I also have links to that in the description box, so please check it out. And let me know what you think of this cake stand. If you also like it, the light blue color. And I will be making more because I like it so much. But then in other colors, of course. But I'm also going to plan another geode on MDF. I think I want to make a geode again. For sure, two. And some coasters. I want to try to recreate some coasters I made. To see if I can recreate the effects. And the colors that I put together. So that's for upcoming videos. So I really appreciate it that you all watch my videos. I want to thank you so much for that. And hopefully I will see you all in another video. Bye.